Most crimes today are solved via surveillance camera, where they can just simply press rewind and then hit play. Doesn't there exist a surveillance camera for the endpoint? And you know, all my incident response buddies looked at me and said, "No, there's no such thing. We have full packet capture for the network, but you can't possibly have an endpoint surveillance camera recording all activity. That's just too much data." And so we had a huge wall of what is too much data, because at the time, with nobody having defined what is an endpoint-based surveillance camera, you know, we literally had to define what is it, what does it collect, and when does it collect these sorts of things. And from my experience as on the offensive side, I knew that you had to always be collecting. And the reason is that once you actually know that that machine is compromised, it's already sort of too late, so to speak. They've already gotten access to the machine and you don't know how. And they might have put other tools down, they might have laterally moved. And so, you know, you have to always be collecting. You have to continuously be collecting this endpoint data in an unfiltered way, because you don't know how the attacker is going to change. You don't know how they're going to morph. And so as you learn and as you pick up new techniques, you want to be able to apply that new learning to historical data and say, hey, have I ever fallen victim to this sort of thing in the past? So we basically stood up and said, all right, well, in this whole wall, like this room filled with all this information that we would want, we started just crossing stuff off. We could get this elsewhere. This isn't really relevant if we had this other information. We really boiled it down to just six key things that we needed to collect all the time. And those six key things are a record of all execution, all file modifications, all registry modifications, all network connections, all cross-process events, and a copy of every unique binary. And if we had those six things, as well as the relationship among them, the cause-effect relationship among them, we felt like, from an attacker's perspective, it would be really hard to hide. It'd be really hard to be present and to continue to use the same methods over and over again without being caught, and to change those methods, those tactics, techniques, or procedures, our behaviors, would be extremely costly. And these are things that we didn't have algorithms to change on a dynamic basis.